Remember, you're meant to be at 7 a.m. tomorrow.
That's not fair.
It's a game over.
My boss was threatening me, that's why my game was low. I have turned 9. What did you feel about that? How does that make you feel?
It's such an incredible journey, and I like to tell people that the iHub's journey is very similar to an entrepreneur's journey. And so every milestone, however big, however small, we always have to celebrate. Mm-hmm. So 9 years, I mean, goodness.
How many years for you?
9.
What was your first role?
First role, operations director.
9 years of the iHub, biggest throwback for you?
Biggest throwback, Eric Schmidt.
Who's Eric Schmidt?
Chairman of Google.
Whoa. Did he visit us?
He visited us, and at that time I had come in to be a lead in building a supercomputer. It was, okay. We actually built a small supercomputer.
Okay.
And we had it running, and he came to then, you know, see the iHub, and he was quite impressed by the fact that, you know, we took hardware that was, you know, disparate hardware, and actually put together a supercomputer using principles of supercomputing. And from then on, he started gushing about how, you know, Africa is going to be the next best place for dev and stuff like that to happen. My first role was iHub manager, because I took over from Tosh.
What do you think were the key partners back then?
The key partners back then were Google, because what we did, we decided as a community to set up user groups. We needed to have a point of focus on where these corporate partners can actually benefit us directly. So we had a Microsoft user group, so Microsoft would come in and then sponsor the user group. We had the Android user group. We also had gotten Oracle to put in some money towards Android development on Java. And then, of course, we had Intel, who then gave us the hardware.
What about the key projects back then? Like, what was a big project maybe in year 3 or 2 that was really big?
Year 2 and 3 were actually around framing what the iHub was going to do moving forward. And I mean, just like, you know, what we've always done is listen to what the needs of the community are, and then figure out what we can do to meet them.
You just mentioned community. How was the community back then?
Back then it was just young, innovative minds that were looking for what was the next big thing that they wanted to be part of. But what I love about that and comparing it to now is they have grown with the iHub. Some of them are still, you know, sitting in the space.
How was it like working with a young crowd?
I was jealous. I was wishing that, like, I could lose like 10 years or 20 years, because a lot of the things that were happening then were things that we were waiting for. I'm part of the generation that Ken Jeroge and all these other guys of Africa Online, and the guys who basically took off with the dot-com boom, were part of, and then it crashed. So us guys went into different things.
What would you say was like the coolest thing about the space then?
The coolest thing about the iHub for me was I got to run away from people, and particularly staying at home. Uh-huh. And I could actually just sit at the iHub and do my own stuff.
As an iHub member, what value do you get right now?
So right now I have clients who trust my work.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, if they come here and I take them to a boardroom, I mean, it looks very professional.
Yeah.
I get to like really charge the actual value of my job, as opposed to when I mean, I couldn't do it before.
How about a big milestone back then?
For me, the biggest milestone back there was in the validation of the idea of the iHub.
Ah.
Yeah, and so it's not that the idea we came up, or the founders came up with the idea in 2010 and then launched. It was that there had been that constant conversations about it for 3 years or maybe more, about the need for a space.
I have access to office space. Being the person I am, I often don't pay much attention to what's happening outside. I mean, pretty much being at the iHub and considering that I get email updates and all of that, I mean, I get to actually gain access to some events that I wouldn't.
There are spaces that you think the iHub needs to start looking into going into the future?
There's going to be the explosion of technologies. Now, just taking, for example, the Internet of Things. How is the iHub going to be involved in the Internet of Things?
Right.
And that's going to be a big deal. I suppose from the iHub, the Gearbox then took off and became, you know, the IoT space.
Yeah.
And so that's the thing. iHub has has all these children that have are doing the things, the, you know, the sector, the space needs?
In terms of community, we're looking forward to growing our community outside of Nairobi. We've had a Nairobi focus to date, although we've done projects outside of Nairobi, outside of Kenya, outside of Africa, but just really looking to grow that Kenya community. And so the work that we're going to be doing in the counties, we've already begun doing that with one of our projects where we've built some labs in Marsabit and Garissa. Mm-hmm. And also our research team is doing some work in Uasin Gishu, in Mombasa and Kisumu. And so that for me is really the thing to look forward to in 2019.
One word that describes the iHub back then and one word that describes it now.
Community.
You heard it from the boss.
Same word.